Princess Diana has long been a subject of public intrigue, but even more people are familiarizing themselves with her controversial life thanks to Netflix's The Crown. The hit series was first released in 2016 and has visually represented each stage of Queen Elizabeth II's reign to date, with season 4 focusing on Princess Diana's relationship with Prince Charles. Season 4 showed the early days of the couple's supposedly unhappy marriage, as Princess Diana, played by Emma Corrin, discovered that Prince Charles's affinity for Camilla Parker Bowles was far from platonic. Diana's growing despondence then led to multiple alleged affairs, something she was unable to hide from the royal family. In one scene during The Crown, Princess Anne jokes with the Queen about Diana's extramarital relationships, including one with her bodyguard, surprisingly.
"Diana's been with her bodyguard, her riding instructor."
Corrin, who starred as Princess Diana, spoke with talk show host Tamron Hall in November 2020.
"The series that we're in is fictionalized to a great extent. Obviously, it has its roots in reality."
Despite being a throwaway line in The Crown, Diana's bodyguard was, in fact, a much bigger part of her life than the show may have led viewers to believe. According to private voice tapes featuring the late princess, she reportedly even considered running off with him at one point. It's no surprise Princess Diana had plenty of admirers, but perhaps her most controversial was her bodyguard, who happened to be the first man she was romantically linked to after Prince Charles. In private tapes recorded in 1992 with Diana's voice coach Peter Cetylin and released after her death, the princess reportedly revealed that her greatest love was her bodyguard. Diana not only expressed being, quote, deeply in love with the man, but is also recorded as saying, "I'd be quite happy to give all this up and to just go off and live with him." While she didn't name him, the mystery man is believed to have been Barry Manicky, a former police officer for the Royal Protection Squad. Back in April 1985, the father of two was assigned to guard Diana as marital tensions escalated between her and Prince Charles. While Manicky's responsibilities included protecting her from unwanted attention or physical harm and accompanying her on trips, his personal affections for the people's princess seemed to go beyond his professional obligations. According to royal expert Tina Brown, Princess Diana and Manicky forged a close relationship during a fishing accident at Balmoral Castle in Scotland. Brown writes in the Diana Chronicles that after Diana injured herself with a salmon hook, it was Manicky who drove the car, Manicky, not her husband, who consoled her. From then on, Diana's bodyguard allegedly continued to support her emotionally, and the pair even publicly flirted with one another, which apparently didn't sit well with royal staffers. Princess Diana never revealed whether her and Barry Manicky's relationship was physical, but one instance suggests that it was. Royal expert Brown wrote that after the pair was caught in a so-called compromising position in 1986, Manicky was fired, while royal staffers like Manicky's successor as bodyguard, Ken Wharf, have said he was simply a friend to the princess. Others disagree and have claimed that there was something more going on between them. Likewise, cavalry officer James Hewitt, who Diana also had an affair with, reportedly claimed that the princess had told him that Manicky was her lover, per Oprah Daily. But as people within the palace, Prince Charles included, caught on to Manicky and Diana's growing intimacy and apparently over-familiar behavior, the 38-year-old was transferred to the Diplomatic Protection Squad, per The Sun. Although, according to Diana's tapes, Manicky was unceremoniously fired from his position. 9 months after leaving his job as Princess Diana's bodyguard, Manicky was killed in a motorbike accident. While making an appearance at the Cannes Film Festival in 1987, Diana said she experienced the, quote, biggest blow of her life. She was told her former bodyguard had died instantly following a collision. Despite being dubbed a tragedy, some believed Manicky's motorbike was tampered with due to his royal romance with the princess. Diana herself was even suspicious and said, "It was all found out and he was chucked out. Then he was killed. I think he was bumped off." Nevertheless, Manicky's death was reinvestigated during the inquiry into Diana's death and was ruled a tragic accident. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about the royal family are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.